की बात करते हैं तो द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट कम्स टू माइंड आर द बीचेस ऑफ गोवा, बट देयर इज सो मच मोर टू एक्सप्लोर हियर बियॉन्ड दैट एंड दैट्स व्हाट वी आर गोना डू टुडे. बट बिफोर दैट लेट्स हैव अ लुक एट द प्रीवियस पार्ट्स इन द गोवा व्लॉग सीरीज.
सो पार्ट 1 और 2 में हमने एक्सप्लोर किए थे नॉर्थ गोवा के कुछ बहुत ही सुंदर बीचेस. इफ यू हैवंट सीन द वीडियोस आई लिंक अप अ कार्ड हियर एंड बिलीव मी ऑल द 3 वीडियोस इन द गोवा सीरीज विल हेल्प यू मेक द मोस्ट आउट ऑफ योर टाइम इन गोवा. सो स्टे ट्यून्ड टिल द एंड, सब्सक्राइब टू माय चैनल इफ यू लाइक इट एंड लेट्स बिगिन.
We checked out of the hotel and we rented a car for the entire day. मेरे साथ है अभी हरि भैया. Hi.
Hi.
So भैया हम कहाँ जा रहे हैं अभी?
अभी हम Spice Plantation जा रहे हैं.
Spice Plantation.
हाँ. दूर दूर से अगर टूरिस्ट आते हैं जैसे.
So really excited for that and let's go check out the plantation.
So my name is Pallavi, I'll be tour guide here.
This is a cashew fenny distillery. Now cashew fenny is the most popular alcoholic drink here, but it's even more popularly used as a medicine in Goa.
That's ginger plant.
The smell is so strong.
It grows like summer, rainy season, winter season. So this is 1 year.
आप एक-एक करके just turn around. Actually ना lavender oil is very famous in spa.
The spice tour was quite fascinating. India is so rich in spices and seeing them in their natural habitat was really good. So if you're looking for something in Goa beyond beaches, go for Spice Plantations. It was a great experience. And now we're having lunch. And they claim that everything on the plate is actually homegrown, of course, except for the bread that they buy from the local market. And it looks quite yummy. Let's try it. It's delicious. We entered Old Goa and right on the entrance was a very famous tourist attraction, the Basilica of Bom Jesus Church. Let's go find out more about this place.
Suddenly started raining and now we are running back to our taxi. Let's see what we end up doing now.
So the initial plan was to visit a few more churches, but it started raining really unexpectedly and very heavily. So we decided to book a hotel which was nearest to us at that time, which is in Panjim. जो कि मीनावार बीच से सिर्फ 5 minutes वॉक है. सो वी आर क्वाइट हैप्पी अबाउट दैट. इट्स आई गेस इट्स आफ्टर ऑल नॉट द एंड ऑफ बीचेस फॉर अस इन गोवा. सो व्हाट डिड वी फाइनली एंड अप डूइंग दिस शॉट टुडे?
वी टुक अ प्लेस नियर द मीनावार बीच एंड वी गॉट टू एक्सप्लोर अनदर बीच थैंकफुली. नाउ वी आर हियर फॉर सम वेरी टेस्टी पाव भाजी.
सो व्हाट डिड वी फाइनली एंड अप डूइंग टुडे दिशा?
सेविंग आवर लाइव्स आई थिंक. सॉरी.
यस, that's how intense the situation got yesterday, but it's just one of those things that traveling teaches you to be grateful for all that you've got. And with that note, let's move on to the next morning in Goa. it's the last morning in Goa and I have a train to catch around 12 to Mumbai. So very few hours left. It's 7 right now?
Yeah,
7. And we are going to the old streets and the churches, the places that we couldn't visit yesterday because of rain. But before that, we decided to walk by the Miramar beach because it was so close to our hotel. And Disha is quite happy about that because she got to see another beach.
Finally!
So there were not a lot of beach shacks at this beach. But in the evening, right outside, you will find a lot of vendors selling yummy street food. That's what we had yesterday. To head to a church called Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception. You see a lot of good pictures of that place, so really looking forward to it.
Church, we walked down to this place called Fountain Hass, and yahan pe bahut hi sundar Portuguese style buildings hai. So let's explore the street.
Time to say bye to Goa, and I booked a cab from the hotel to the Madgaon railway station, jahan se meri train hai Mumbai ke liye. And I'm quite excited for the train journey because it is said to be one of the most beautiful train journeys in India. Because ye guzarti hai Dudh Sagar waterfall se bhi, jo ki India ki second largest waterfall hai. Series, and since this is the last part, I thought I'll come in here and share some more information that I could gather on the trip. So here goes. So for places other than Panjim, the two most convenient options are to either rent a scooty, which is also the most economical way, or to use the state-run application called Goa Miles, which operates in a similar fashion as Uber and Ola. Well, the general opinion is November to January, but it's also the time when it's way too crowded and the prices are 5 times the normal rate. So if you, like us, wish to travel in a budget and avoid the crowd, the best time would be late in the month of October, late in January, or early in February, when the weather will be quite pleasant and it won't be too crowded as well. I'd say it's as safe or as unsafe as any other destination in India. So yes, a solo trip can definitely be planned in Goa, provided you keep all solo travel tips in mind, which I also shared in one of my previous videos, the link to which I'll put in the description box below. Well, Goa is said to be the party capital of India, but we did not visit the place with that agenda in mind as much. But I met someone who happens to have a lot of suggestions on where to party in Goa, so do note them down.
So here in Ole Paran Kitchen, I met Arti.
Hi. Goa, best place to chill, and especially if you are with your girl gang, nothing like that.
Yeah. Any suggestions of must visit places in Goa?
Must visit places. Entrees, especially on a weekend.
Okay.
It's really good. Shiva's Valley, especially on a Tuesday night.
Shiva's Valley?
Yeah, it's at Anjuna. Okay. On a Tuesday night, it's that trance kind of music. Post dinner, late night music one.
Okay.
Like dancing on the beach and everything. So yeah. Shiva's Valley is the place for it.
It is nice meeting you.
Nice meeting you. Ciao.
So hope you found the information helpful, and with that, wish you all a very, very happy new year, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.